Good morning, students.
Good morning, ma'am.
Good morning, all. All of you, please switch on your videos. Okay. So, in our last class, we just started. I will give you an introduction to a topic, relative velocity. So, today we are going to discuss about the relative velocity, whatever the mathematical expression for relative velocity and all. I hope that the concept is clear to you. What do you mean by relative velocity? Actually, it is nothing. It's a comparison. It's a relation between the two velocity. Okay. So for that, here we consider two velocity such that the velocity of one object should be kept constant, or it should be taken as a reference standard, and we compare the velocity of the second object with that of the velocity of the first object. That is what is known as relative velocity. So in order to calculate the relative velocity, we must consider two objects and such that these two objects possess their own velocity. Suppose if we consider two objects A and B, velocity of object A is taken as VA and velocity of object B is taken as VB, such that we can compare the velocity of these two objects. If we want to compare the velocity of object B with respect to object A, there will be an equation for calculation. Similarly, one vice versa, we can calculate the velocity of object A with respect to that of the object B. So this is what is known as relative velocity. So all of you first write the definition for relative velocity. Write the heading relative velocity and write the definition for relative velocity. Next heading, relative velocity. Relative velocity. Okay, it is the velocity of an object. It is the velocity of an object. It is the velocity of an object with respect to another object. It is the velocity of an object with respect to another object. You just recall about the marks. When we get the marks, we just compare our marks with that of our friends. So that is what is we mean by the term relative, in relation with. How many marks more than or lesser than that of our friend? Just a comparison. That is what you mean by relative, in relation with the other person. Okay. So relative velocity means it is the velocity of one object. It is the velocity of an object with respect to another object. It is the velocity of an object with respect to another object. And that object may be, sometimes it may be in a state of rest, or it is moving with a constant velocity. Sometimes it may be moving with a less velocity or a higher velocity, whatever it may be. If you are compare the velocity of these two objects, then we can call it as a relative velocity. It is the velocity of one object with respect to another object. Is it clear? Okay, now, right, after that, right? Consider two objects. Consider two objects, A and B. Consider two objects, A and B, with velocities, VA and VB respectively. Consider two objects, A and B, with velocities VA and VB respectively. That is, VA is the velocity of object A and VB is the velocity of object B. Consider two objects, A and B, with velocities VA and VB respectively. Then relative velocity of relative velocity of object A, relative velocity of object A with respect to object B is given by, here we consider two objects A and B with velocities VA and VB respectively. Then relative velocity of object A with respect to, here this WRT is a short form for with respect to, object A with respect to object B is given by VA minus VB, sorry, VAB, that is given by, relative velocity is given by VAB is equal to VA minus VB. Okay, so here we have two objects or two bodies, object A and object B, having velocities VA and VB respectively, such that we want to calculate the relative velocity of object A. So here we are going to find out the relative velocity of object A. So give preference to that velocity first. Okay, VAB, relative velocity of object A with respect to object B. So VAB is equal to VA minus VB. This is the expression for relative velocity of object A with respect to object B. Okay. Similarly, the relative velocity of object B with respect to object A. Similarly, the relative velocity of object B with respect to object A is given by, try to form an equation for calculating the relative velocity of object B with respect to object A. Just guess. Yes, it is VBA. VBA is equal to VB minus VA. So here we want to calculate the relative velocity of object B with respect to A. So give preference to object B here. Okay, so VBA is equal to VB minus VA. Simple subtraction, nothing more than that. Okay, so here this is the mathematical expression for the relative velocity between two objects. So in order to calculate the relative velocity, we must consider the two objects with their own velocity and compare the velocity of one object with respect to the other. If you are compare the velocity of object A with respect to object B, the equation is of the form VAB is equal to VA minus VB. Similarly, if you are comparing the relative velocity of object B with respect to object A, then the equation becomes VBA is equal to VB minus VA. Okay, so now we can do one problem regarding with this relative velocity. Try to copy down this question. Rain is falling vertically with a speed of 35 meter per second. A woman rides a bicycle with a speed of 12 meter per second in east to west direction. Find the relative velocity of rain with respect to bicycle. If you are consider the motion of an object in a plane, the speed is nothing, it is the velocity of the object. So rain is falling vertically with a speed or velocity of 35 meter per second. A woman rides a bicycle with a speed of 12 meter per second. Then find the relative velocity of rain with respect to bicycle. What are the parameters are given here? What about the velocity of rain? We can take and it is Vr, velocity of rain. Velocity or speed, both are same. Velocity of rain is 35 meter per second. What about the velocity of bicycle? Vb, that is equal to 12 meter per second. And our question is this. Find the relative velocity of rain with respect to bicycle. Try to form an equation. Vr is equal to 35 meter per second. Vb is equal to 12 meter per second. Then what about the relative velocity of rain with respect to bicycle?
Vr minus Vb.
Yes. And what about the LHS? Vrb. Vrb is equal to Vr minus Vb. That is equal to 35 minus 12. Final answer. Yes, Niranjan, what about the final answer?
23.
Yeah, it is 23 meter per second. So the relative velocity of rain with respect to bicycle is 23 meter per second. Okay. So this is a simple portion from this chapter, motion in a plane, relative velocity. Actually, here we are comparing the velocity of one object with respect to the other object. The velocity of both objects should be given in the question. So that's all about the relative velocity. Is there any doubt regarding with this topic, relative velocity? No. Okay. So now the next topic, write the next heading, projectile motion. Projectile motion. Next topic, projectile motion. This is one of the most important topic of this lesson, motion in a plane, projectile motion. Okay. Then have you heard about this term projectile before? What do you mean by projectile? Any idea? Yes, Malavika. Malavika is ready to say something.
Yes, ma'am, the motion after a force being applied. Or...
Yes, it is a motion of an object after a force applied on it, right?
Yes.
Okay, then what about others? Is there any other opinion or can you make a definition for what you mean by projectile? Bahrain, is there any idea about projectile?
Motion of object thrown.
The motion of an object thrown. If you are thrown a stone into air, it's a projectile. It follows a projectile motion, right? Okay. So first of all, I will give you an idea about what you mean by projectile. What do you mean by projectile? After that, we can discuss about projectile motion. So projectile is a name that is given to an object. Okay. But it is needed to satisfy some condition, then only we can call it as a projectile. So projectile is a name that is given to an object if it is project into the earth atmosphere. So one condition is it is project into the earth atmosphere and it moves under the influence of gravity alone. Then the third condition, if it is creates a parabolic path, then we can call such object as a projectile. Okay, so there are three conditions are there. An object should be projected into the earth atmosphere. The second one, no external force is acting on it except the gravitational force. Only the gravitational force is acting on that object. And if this object is follows or it is creates a parabolic path, then we can call such object as a projectile. So you just imagine if I throw a stone into the air, it is go into the vertical direction. Does it is a projectile? If it is follows a parabolic path, then only I can call it as a projectile. So projectile is a name that is given to an object which is project into the earth atmosphere and comes under the influence or follows under the influence of gravitational force. And it is, if it is creates a parabolic path, we can call it as a projectile. And the object which follows a motion, the motion possessed by this projectile is known as projectile motion. Okay, so let us see what about the definition of this projectile first. Projectile, any object which is projected in the air is called a projectile. Any object which is projected in the air and which having an initial velocity, it must possess an initial velocity. Any object which is projected in the air, add some more points along with it, with an initial velocity an object which is projected in the air with an initial velocity and that comes under the influence of gravity alone, under the influence of, and that comes under the influence of gravity alone, and if it creates a parabolic path, then we can call it as a projectile. Or you can write this definition, after that you can write a subheading, characteristics of a projectile. It should possess an initial velocity, it moves under the influence of gravitational force alone, and it creates a parabolic path. Any object which is projected into the air with an initial velocity and that comes under the influence of gravity alone, and if it is creates a parabolic path, then such objects is known as projectile. Such objects are known as projectile. Is it clear? Yes, Mary Angelina, is there any doubt regarding with the definition?
No, ma'am.
Okay. So it must possess an initial velocity. No other force is acting on it. You just imagine if you are throw a stone into the air. So after, whenever it is gone out from our hands, is there any other external forces acting on it? No external forces acting on the stone. It is moves only under the influence of gravity. Okay. So it is moves under the influence of gravity. Only the gravitational force is acting on that object and it should follow a parabolic path. Parabola. Parabolic path is something like this path. This is what is known as parabolic path. Okay. This is what is known as projectile. Any object which is projected into the air with an initial velocity and that comes under the influence of gravity alone, and if it is creates a parabolic path, we can call it as a projectile. Then what do you mean by projectile motion? Projectile motion is a motion in which an object is thrown near the earth's surface and it moves along the curved path under the action of gravity only. Or in simple words, you can see the motion possessed by the projectile is known as projectile motion. Because almost all the other characteristics possessed by the projectile that we are already discussed in the first slide. So you can write the motion followed by a projectile is known as projectile motion. Projectile motion is a motion in which an object is thrown near the earth's surface and it moves along the curved path under the action of gravity only. This is what is known as projectile motion. It is follows a curved path. This curved path is known as parabola. Sometimes they may be asked the definition for projectile or projectile motion along with that of the calculation. Says as a part of sub question. Is it over? So here you can see some examples for the projectile motion. Motion of a snowboarder descending from a slope. Okay, motion of a snowboarder descending from a slope. It's an example for projectile motion. Motion of a rider performing a bike stunt, or motion of a water jets coming out from nozzles. All these are some examples for the projectile motion. Okay. So next topic, point of projection. These are some terms associated with this topic, projectile motion. The next one is point of projection. What do you mean by point of projection? The point from which the object is projected into the earth is known as point of projection. So here, if you are standing here and project the object into the earth, so from which point the object is projected into the air, that point is known as point of projection. The point from which the object is projected into the air is called as point of projection. Okay, the point from which the object is projected in air is called point of projection. This is the next term associated with that of the projectile motion. The next one, velocity of projection. The velocity with which an object is projected in air is called velocity of projection. The velocity with which an object is projected into the air is known as velocity of projection. The point from which the object is projected is known as point of projection. The velocity at which the object is projected into the air is known as velocity of projection. So as in the beginning of the class, we just say that the object should be projected into the air with an initial velocity. It should possess an initial velocity. That initial velocity is known as the velocity of projection. Okay, that is what is known as the velocity of projection. Now the next term associated with the projectile motion is angle of projection. The angle with the horizontal at which the object is projected into the air is called angle of projection. Horizontal means it is the ground level. We are standing in a ground and we are thrown the object into or project the object into the air. So the angle with which the horizontal at which an object is projected in air is called angle of projection. Angle between the projection of object and that of the horizontal. This is what is known as angle of projection. The angle with which the horizontal at which an object is projected in air is called angle of projection. The angle with the horizontal at which an object is projected in air is called angle of projection. Okay, so the next term associated with the projectile motion is trajectory. Here we, in our derivation, we are going to use all these terms. That's why first of all I will give you a brief introduction about these terms. The next term, it's a new term, trajectory. What do you mean by trajectory? Trajectory means nothing, it is a path, the path followed by the projectile. Okay, the parabolic path followed by a projectile in air is called a trajectory. Trajectory is nothing, it is the path followed by the projectile in during the projectile motion. And we know that in a projectile motion, the trajectory is nothing, it is a parabola. It is in the form of a parabola. The parabolic path followed by a projectile in air is called its trajectory. We will find an expression for this angle of projection, maximum height of this projectile motion, and we are discussing about the trajectory and horizontal length of the projectile and all. So that is why I will give you an introduction about this term. So trajectory is nothing, it is the parabolic path that is followed by the projectile during its motion. And next one is time of flight. I think you don't need to copy down this time of flight, it's now, we will discuss it later. Maximum height also. Okay, anyway, we can start. All the other terms are some basic concepts about the projectile. So projectile is nothing. First of all, we can make a definition of projectile. After that, we can quickly recall all these points. After that, we can go through with the derivation of this projectile. So starting with Tom Sebastian, what do you mean by projectile?
Any object which is projected in the air with the initial velocity and that follows a parabolic path and is only influenced by gravity.
Okay, and it is only influenced by the gravitational force. That is what is known as projectile. Then Anne-Mary, what do you mean by projectile motion?
Projectile motion is a motion which an object is thrown near the Earth's surface and it moves along the curved path under the action of gravity.
Okay, then Sanjana, point of projection?
The point from which the object is projected in air.
Okay, then Shreya, what do you mean by angle of projection? Okay, Alina, no problem. Angle of projection? Gaya, angle of projection? Okay, Pranav, what do you mean by angle of projection?
The angle with the horizontal at which an object is projected in the air.
Yes, it is the angle between the projected object and that of the horizontal. Okay, very good. Then about a Meryl, velocity of projection.
The velocity with which an object is projected in the air is called velocity of
projection. Okay, the velocity at which the object is projected into the air is known as velocity of projection. So that's all about some important terms associated with that of the projectile motion. Now we are going to discuss how this projectile motion is occurs. What about the velocities accompanying with that of this projectile motion and all. Okay, so let us see. So for that, here we consider an object that is projected into the air. Consider an object which is projected into the air. So here we have the point of projection. What do you mean by point of projection? It is the point from which the object is projected into the air. So here we have the point of projection. We consider it as O. Now I throw a stone or a ball, something like that, into the air with an initial velocity U. So this U is known as velocity of projection, the velocity at which the object is projected into the air or atmosphere is known as velocity of projection. So here I throw some object into the air from this point of projection. So here we know that the velocity is initial velocity, it is represented by U. And we know that velocity is a type of physical quantity, it is a vector quantity. Is it a scalar or vector? Velocity. Velocity is a vector quantity because it has both the magnitude and the direction. And here, this object which is projected into the atmosphere or air with an initial velocity is inclined at an angle theta with the horizontal. We are standing in a horizontal at ground. So this is the ground. And we throw some object into the atmosphere or into air with an initial velocity u. We know that velocity is a vector quantity. It is inclined at an angle theta with that of the horizontal. Okay, it is inclined at an angle theta. Then students, can you guess what happens to this velocity vector? It's a vector quantity. Try to correlate the concept with some concept that we are already discussed in the class. If a vector is inclined at an angle theta, one phenomenon is possible here. What is that? Try to quickly recall about the resolution of vectors. What do you mean by resolution of vectors? Resolution of vectors. No idea.
Compound.
Yes, resolution of vector. That is related to velocity. What do you mean by resolution of vector? Resolution of vector. Resolving of vector. Resolving. For example, if we have a resultant vector, vector r, we resolved it into small components. Did you remember? Yes, very good. Resolution means nothing. It is a splitting of a large vector into its small components. It is possible if and only if the vector is inclined at an angle theta. Does the resolution of vector is possible for parallel vectors? Is it possible? No, because the angle between these two vectors are equal to zero. It is not possible for anti-parallel vectors because the angle between them is equal to 180 degree. So while we are discussing about the resolution of vectors, we are already told that the resolution of vectors is possible for only those vectors which is inclined at an angle theta. This is a basic information about the vectors you must kept in your mind. It will be helpful for your higher classes or for the plus two also. Okay. So the resolution of vectors is possible if and only if the vectors are inclined at an angle theta. It is resolved into two components. One is a horizontal component and other is a vertical component. So here we have an initial vector. This initial vector is nothing but the initial velocity u. So this vector u is inclined at an angle theta. It is inclined at an angle theta with that of the horizontal. So here we can split this initial vector, velocity vector u, into two components. What are they? One is a horizontal component that is taken along the x-axis. So we can take it as ux. And other is a vertical component that is taken as uy. It is taken along the y-axis. Okay. So here we consider an object which is projected into the air with an initial velocity u. Since it is a vector quantity, this initial velocity vector u can be resolved into two components because it is inclined at an angle theta. Here the initial velocity vector is inclined at an angle theta. Any vector which is inclined at an angle theta, the next step is we can resolve that vector into two components. One is a horizontal component and other is a vertical component. So here we are divide this total initial velocity vector into its smaller parts. One is a small velocity component along the x-axis and other is a small velocity component that along the y-axis. Okay. And another thing that you must keep in your mind, the component that is taken along the x-axis should take cos theta value. That is, u is equal to, along the x-axis, it take ux cos theta. This is a new concept for you. Okay. If you are resolve any vector into two components, one is horizontal component, other is a vertical component, the component that is taken along the x-axis should be a cos function, and the component that is taken along the vertical axis should be a sine function. That is, along the y-axis, it is u by sine theta. You must keep this point in your mind always while resolving the vectors. This is a new concept for you. You only know that the resolution of vectors is possible if the vectors are inclined at an angle theta. We can resolve it into two components. One is a horizontal component and other is a vertical component. Here we are introducing a new concept today, that is the component that along the x-axis should be taken cos function. It is ux cos theta. Similarly, the component that we are resolved along the vertical axis is taken as uy sine theta. This is sine function. This constant in physics. It's a constant concept in physics. The component that is resolved along the x-axis is a cos function. The component that is taken along the vertical axis is a sine function. So ux cos theta and uy sine theta. So we resolve the initial velocity vector u into two components. One is along the horizontal axis. It is taken as ux cos theta. You must keep this point in your mind. This is a concept we are used in physics. Okay. And the component that is resolved along the vertical axis is always taken as u by sine theta. Not only in the case of velocity vector, you suppose if you are imagine that you consider it is an acceleration vector which is inclined at an angle theta. Any vector which is inclined at an angle theta, we can resolve it into two components. One is a horizontal component along the x-axis, other is a vertical component along the y-axis. And the component that is taken along the x-axis is ax cos theta. Okay, cos theta component is always taken along the horizontal axis, and along the vertical axis, its value is ay sine theta. You must keep this point in your mind for your higher classes. Okay, so here initially we have withdrawn an object into the air with an initial velocity u, but this initial velocity vector which is inclined at an angle theta, so we resolve this initial velocity vector into two component. One is along the horizontal axis, other is along the y axis, vertical axis. Horizontal component is taken the value ux cos theta, vertical component is takes the value uy sine theta. Okay. Now the next point, horizontal component remains constant throughout the projectile motion of object. Horizontal component remains constant throughout the motion. Okay, here we have two components, horizontal component and a vertical component. Horizontal component remains constant. There is no change in its value from the initial state to the final state. It remains constant throughout the motion, throughout the projectile motion. But vertical component may vary under the influence of gravity. Okay, horizontal component remains the same, but vertical component may vary. It is depends upon the acceleration due to gravity that is acted along this projectile. Okay. So here we are going to describe the path followed by this projectile. So here this is the point of projection from which we are projected an object into the Earth atmosphere. After some time, suppose you imagine the object is here. After some time, if the object is reaches at point A, so here also we can resolve this velocity vector into two components. One is ux cos theta, but here the vertical component is split into two. One is a vertical component, that is u y sine theta. But when the object is reaches here, one more vertical component is acting on this projectile. What is that? What are the two forces can be act on the object when it is reaches here? After projecting it, now no more. Yes, yes, it is the. Yes, it's right. It is the gravitational force, acceleration due to gravity, the gravitational force of the earth. After we are throwing or projecting the object into the atmosphere, then we have no role on that object. Then everything else, after that, everything else is take place under the influence of gravity. Okay, so here one more force is acting on the object, that is nothing, it is the acceleration due to gravity. And we know that according to the laws of motion, V is equal to u plus at. V is equal to u plus at. Okay, here we only need to consider that of the initial velocity. Initial velocity V is equal to u plus at. Or we you don't need to consider the equation. What do you mean by velocity? Velocity V is equal to what is velocity? Velocity, the basic concept of motion of an object. Or what do you mean by acceleration? I think it is better. What do you mean by acceleration?
Rate of change of velocity.
Rate of change of velocity, v by t. Here we consider the object which is moving with an initial velocity u. So we can write the equation a is equal to u by t. And here the acceleration is nothing, it is the acceleration due to gravitational force of the earth. So it is acceleration due to gravity g. Instead of a, here we are used to denote it with the g. G is equal to u by t. Then what is the initial velocity that is acting on the object due to this acceleration due to gravity? U is equal to gt, g into t. Okay. So once again, I will explain this. Or after some time, the object is reaches at a point A. And as we told earlier, the horizontal component remains constant throughout the motion. So ux cos theta remains the same. But when the object is projected into the atmosphere or into the air, then its vertical component may vary. One is uy sine theta, but at the same time, an acceleration due to gravity or a gravitational force is exerted on this object that is acting downwards. So due to that, the velocity of the object may become varies. And that velocity is given by, from the equation we know that acceleration is nothing, it is the rate of change of velocity v by t. But here we consider the initial velocity. So a is equal to u by t. Instead of v, here we consider u. So which implies initial velocity u is equal to at. Again, here we consider the acceleration. The acceleration is due to gravitational force of the earth. That is what is known as acceleration due to gravity. It is represented by a letter g. We have studied all these concepts in lower classes. So u is equal to gt. And this velocity is acting in which direction? It is in downward direction. So here, one component of velocity, that is a vertical component uy sine theta, but when the object is reaches at the point A, due to the gravitational force of the earth, the velocity becomes varies. One more velocity component is added here. It is due to the gravitational force of the earth that is acting downwards. U is equal to gt. Okay. Again, after some time, the object is reaches here. That is the maximum height position. Object is reaches at the point B. After some times, object is point at B. What about the horizontal component? Horizontal component here. No idea. After some times, the object is reaches at the point B. What about the horizontal component?
Ux cos theta.
Very good. It is Ux cos theta. There is no change in the horizontal component throughout the motion of the object. Here also, the velocity vertical component may varies. One is Uy sin theta and the vertical component due to the acceleration due to gravity. That is U is equal to Gt. Okay, now it is 11:50. We can discuss the same in our next class.